You are listening to A Voice in the Desert, where we take a deep dive into the Holy Word of God. We are located in Isabela, Puerto Rico. Our podcast is aimed for everyone. A Voice in the Desert motto is, everyone's welcome because nobody's perfect. But we believe that anything's possible. A Voice in the Desert aims to be culturally relevant when talking about God's Word in our time, plus a lot of other very important topics to our times. And now, your host, Caesar, A Voice in the Desert. Hi, brothers and sisters. Welcome to A Voice in the Desert once again. Today, we're getting ready to share the word with you. And it's going to be a very deep word. It's going to be a word that's going to open up your eyes to the unnatural, to the supernatural, to the battle between good and evil. It's also going to be describing and revealing to you one of the evil spirits that are prevalent right now in our current age. Okay? The title of the message for today is The Evil Spirit of Jezebel. And this is just the first series. This is going to be a two-part series, and this is just going to be the first part today, where we're going to be talking about the evil spirit of Jezebel. Okay? This is the end of times we're living in a terrible moment. And the spirit of this dangerous demon called Jezebel is at work at our current age. Dear brethren, remember, this is a moment that we are sharing the undiluted word of God and preparing the brethren for the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. We sincerely thank God for the people that have been following our message of the word of God and some of the amazing facts happening around the world today. We appreciate your love towards this broadcast, your emails and support to see that the truth is revealed in this last hour. We still warn the unbelieving world about the fast approaching judgments of God in this series. We are going to look at a dangerous spirit prevalent in this present age. It can be seen in a life, church, society, and nation. The knowledge of these facts will help you understand where we are and what to expect, because a lot of things are happening these days. Let us pray, as we always do. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. Our Heavenly Father, sanctify us with your word, for your word is truth. Minister knowledge and wisdom to us through your revelation, and bring to us the fullness of your understanding. Thank you, Lord, as all the glory will be returned to you through Christ, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. We're going to go ahead and we're going to start this message with the book of Revelations, chapter 2, verses 18 through 29. And the word of God said, and the angel of the church in Thyatira writes, these things saith the Son of God, who hath his eyes like a flame of fire, and his feet are like unto burnished brass. I know thy works, and thy love, and faith, and ministry, and patience, and thy last works are more than the first. But I have this against thee, that thou sufferest the woman Jezebel, who call herself a prophetess. And she teacheth and seduceth my servants to commit fornication and to eat things sacrificed to idols. And I give her time that she should repent. And she willeth not to repent of her fornication. Behold, I cast her into a bed, and them that commit adultery with her into great tribulation, except they repent of her works. And I will cure her children with death. And all the churches shall know that I am he that searcheth the reins and hearts, and I will give unto each one of you according to your works. But to you I say, the rest that are in Thyatira, as many as have not this teaching, who know not the deep things of Satan, as they are wont to say, I cast upon you none other burden. Nevertheless, that which ye have, hold fast till I come. And he that cometh and keepeth my works unto the end, To him I will give authority over the nations, and he shall rule them with a rod of iron, as the vessels of the potter are broken to shivers, as I also have received of my Father, and I will give him the morning star. He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith to the church. From the passage, we see the church at Thyatira, one of the seven churches of the book of Revelation, as shown to the servant of God, John, in the island of Patmos. They were commended for their works, their charity, service, faith, patience, and last deeds by the Son of God, who has eyes like a flame of fire and his feet like fine brass. The last word in the passage shows that the church outdid herself. Her works was greater towards the end of her lifetime than they were at the beginning. Wow, that's a great commendation. But there was something deep-rooted problem as well. This drew my attention. What was the problem? We see it in verse 20 of the passage. But I have this against thee, that thou sufferest the woman Jezebel, who calleth herself a prophetess, and she teacheth and seduceth my servant to commit fornication and to eat things sacrificed to idols. The church allowed a germ which gave a big name to herself. God said that woman is his problem. Her duty was to teach and seduce God's servants to commit fornication and to eat things sacrificed unto idols. No wonder the holy God pronouncement judgment against her and her followers. God gave a space for her repentance, but she prefers to suffer by the hands of an angry God in the great tribulation. Friends, I'm talking about the spirit of this woman. One may ask, what? Jezebel. Didn't she die back in the book of 2 Kings? How can this woman be threatening the church in Asia? Obviously, the literal person of Jezebel was not present in Thyatira. The reference is a prophetic parallel. The influence in this city was under the spiritual control of the same demonic influences that controlled Jezebel of old. We are living in a terrible moment, and the spirit of this dangerous woman called Jezebel is at work in our current present age. Remember, I mentioned initially in our previous message of A Voice in the Desert that history has its usual way of repeating itself. And secondly, when any age is about to close, there's always a rise in wickedness and iniquity. Jesus Christ in the passage read, canceled good works because of a refusal of a life, church, and society to deal with the spirit of Jezebel. So one of the highest spirits in the end times is that of Jezebel. Jezebel, who she is and what she does. We are about to expose her for all her evil. You may be surprised that in this hour of human history, she is your number one spiritual enemy. I wanted to take this moment to make a special note. Angels were never seen in vision or human form, always biblically appear male. Through their celestial estate, can't be compared to our human sexuality. You can see that in Matthew 23:20. Whoso therefore shall swear by the altar sweareth by it and by all things thereon. Therefore, it can be assumed that the demonic manifestation of Jezebel, a male for the purpose of evil appearance in feminine form in this message, when the pronouns she or her are used in reference to Jezebel as an evil spirit, they should nor be taken as literal gender identifications. Female pronouns be employed as a literacy device referencing the female activity and the intent of Jezebel as a fallen angel. Remember, John the Revelator warned us that she comes as a prophetess concealing her true motives. What better way to destroy the work of God than by infiltrating at the highest ranks of spiritual leadership. Preachers, teachers, deacons, elders, men, women, from the pulpit to the pastor's home. The story of Jezebel has it all. Sex, intrigue, religious, apostasy, nefarious, schemes, fraud, treason, and tragedy. Jezebel still lives on as the archetype liberated womanhood, despoiled and fearsome. For the first time, a king of Israel has joined in marriage with a heathen. Disaster was surely to follow. This unholy alliance was to be Israel's eventual undoing. Jezebel played the role of political consort. Well, by bringing along 850 of her Baal prophets to replace the worship of Yahweh, of our God, Jehovah, eventually murdering several Jewish prophets, for the first time in Israel's history, there was a great organized official persecution of those faithful to the true living God, Jehovah. Jezebel was unrestrained in her hatred for the religious piety over the people that she governed. Okay, she was very ruthless. Idolatry in all its Phoenician splendor, now the dominated, the religion, tenor of the Jewish kingdom. Let's go back again, and I want you to listen to this. She reigned, idolatry in all Phoenician splendor, now the dominated religion tenor of the Jewish kingdom. She was able to go ahead and replace the worship that was due to our true living God, Jesus Christ, our Lord, our Savior, our Jehovah. She was able to replace it into these fanatical, idolatrous types of beings and false prophets. Okay? This new religion of Baal worship also brought with it the basest kind of practices such as sensual temple prostitution, licentious rituals, which is another way of saying promiscuous and unprincipled in sexual matter. That's very important. Remember that. That's one of the characteristics of the spirit. They also participated in infanticide rituals, which is the killing of a child within a year of birth. It is clear from the Bible this Phoenician interloper was not content to be on a throne and play second fiddle to her husband. Okay? She brought with her from her own country all the accoutrements of her culture. It had to be obvious to the religious Israelites that the entire country was turning away from the reason for their existence, their connection to the one true God, Jehovah. We're going to read in 1 Kings chapter 16, verses 29 through 33, it says, and the word of God says, and in 38 years of Asa king of Judah, began Ahab the son of Omri to reign over Israel. And Ahab the son of Omri reigned over Israel in Samaria 22 years. And Ahab the son of Omri did which was evil in the sight of Jehovah above all that were before him. And it came to pass, as if it had been like a light thing for him to walk in the sins of Jeroboam and the son of Nebat, that he took to wife Jezebel, the daughter of Ethbaal, king of the Sidonians, and went and served Baal and worshipped him. And he reared up an altar for Baal in the house of Baal, which he had built in Samaria. And Ahab made Asherah, and Ahab did not yet more to provoke Jehovah, the God of Israel, to anger than all the kings of Israel that were before him. From the passage, we have seen that the woman Jezebel was the daughter of Ethbaal, the king of Sidon. The king and high priest of the Baal-worshipping Sidonians. You should know that Baal worship was associated with obsessive sensuality and often involved sexual acts. So Jezebel was raised in an atmosphere where sex was path to power and influence. She later became the queen of Ahab, the king of Israel. She grew up in a kingdom and finally landed in another kingdom. She had all the kingdom lifestyles, activities, intrigues, maneuvers, and the politics of the palace in her fingertips. Ahab, king of Israel, was completely subdued and dominated by Jezebel, then introduced the worship of Asherah to Israel. This goddess, represented in Canaanite culture by the moon, was a power-hungry goddess of love and sensuality. Priestess prostitutes filled her shrines and serviced her worshipers. The men of Israel, I want you to listen to this, people. The men of Israel would not resist her erotic encounters. Can you imagine? Over 10 million Israelites left the worship of Jehovah for Baal and Asherah. Thank God for only 7,000 people in the entire nation who were not swayed by her control. Friend, the physical figure called Jezebel had died long ago and buried according to the judgment of God, but her spirit is still at work in many lives, many families, many churches, and nations today. She is a great force at work, and is not just a physical being. It is the spirit in the end time propagating the false agenda of the Antichrist, the soon coming dictator, and demons at work at currently in our age, which are like armies. So there is a spiritually motivated take charge woman that the Lord Jesus Christ calls Jezebel. So the spirit Jezebel is here with us. We are now living during a strange and unusual time of uncertain length, which the Bible calls space to repent. How can it be identified? Knowing all these things make you feel in this dangerous times. Many things are unfolding in this last hour. Be on the watch so you, that you shall not be a victim of many satanic agendas today. In series one of this message, the spirit called Jezebel, we shall search for it in our lives. Remember, although it may be common to refer to Jezebel as she, we must obviously conclude that as a spirit, Jezebel is gender neutral. The spirit can be seen in a man or a woman. Really, Jezebel is a spirit, but it has found access through uncrucified flesh. Ahab the king would have been good if not Jezebel. Friend, your spirit would have prospered if not your flesh, which was Jezebel staying closer, monitoring the king. Jezebel means cohabitation, meaning an attachment to your soul, striving over it. How can one identify this spirit in an individual life, church, society, or in these final hours? It is a spirit which can admit a wrong. Brethren, when you fail to admit your wrong, this spirit is in operation. Jezebel. Not a good name. Jezebel's spirit is never wrong unless it is a temporary admittance to guilt to gain favor with someone. To accept responsibility would violate the core pride and insecurity in which it operates. What are we not seeing today? Some lives would brag in arrogant pride about murdering a little baby. Some people today promote evil and will never admit they're wrong. Satan is deceiving them. You should know now that a man who gave the world the satanic Bible, which promotes Satanism in some lives, is wrong. The man, Anton LaVey, born in April 11th, 1930, and was and still is known as the father of modern Satanism, was the creator and the high priest of the first satanic church in San Francisco, California. The church was created in April 30th, 1966 to celebrate man's carnal beast that lived in the cosmos, motivated by the dark force known as Satan. When Levi died, he leaves the church of Satan under the commanding powers of the current church's current high priestess, Blanche Burton. Today, many people are practicing satanic teachings and believing the New Age doctrines such as admittance of the so-called alternate lifestyles, reincarnations, and many other evil doings. They are wrong. Brethren, what do you believe and what do you practice today? It is a spirit which uses people to accomplish satanic agendas. That is its main mission. That is what Jezebel mainly does. The Jezebel spirit lets other do its dirty work. Jezebel gets another person's emotions stirred up, then lets that person go into a rage. The spirit is clever in its agenda. The spirit of Jezebel is the one of the Antichrist. The enemy is sending many people for a work day, for a work today. Many people are just happy slaves. People are satanically possessed. The symbols are everywhere. The celebrities and some politicians make signs of Baphomet. And we all know that is the shape of the goat of the face of Satan. And exchange secret handshakes. The world is going on, is it not? Brethren, can't you read the writing on the world? As you pursue for success and breakthroughs, you are ruled by this wicked spirit of the last days. Maybe you still use people to accomplish satanic agenda or being used. You have to repent today before it becomes too late. It volunteers for anything. A Jezebel volunteers in order to establish control. He seemingly has endless energy and eagerly looks for opportunities to be in charge of projects. Although you may work hard, but your motive is never pure. Jezebel's spirit control through manipulation. This is now seen rapidly happening in our churches, trying to jockey for positions of honor and consider themselves above all. No, they know not that the church is not a building in which they try to govern with the spirit of Jezebel. Brethren, if you have a deep hatred for true spiritual authority and use emotional pressure, witchcraft, obsessive sensuality in your pursuit for power, then this is the spirit that is working in you. Some men of God are now using subtle persuasion to gain influence and to get close to get what they want. Men of God, are you having your way in your ministry through manipulation? For cheap gain and covetousness, you twist some lies to get through? You may succeed here, but you will regret it later. I pity this generation and some of our so-called preachers. It is living by wickedness. The book of 1 Kings chapter 19 verses 1 and 2. And Ahab told Jezebel all that Elijah had done, and withal how he had slain all the prophets with the swords. Then Jezebel sent a messenger unto Elijah saying, so let the gods do to me and more also, if I make not thy life as the life of one of them by tomorrow about this time. Jezebel had the power to send a messenger to the prophet of God showing her wickedness. She sent word to Elijah the prophet, sentencing him to death within 24 hours. It is a spirit displaying wickedness on the earth today. Some of our families and nations have sunk to the deepest depths of Satan. There are volumes of wickedness in our society, and lives today. I see the Spirit in people's lives, families, and nations today. When Brother Jeff King, the president of Christian Council International, told the world about how one of the communist governments has murdered hundreds of tribal Christians to show her wickedness, only the wise understood him because of this end time spirit. A particular group was tortured by painful drug injections. The military personnel was administered. The drugs were brutal to force the people to not believe in Jesus. One Christian reported, "We all got sick, and it was different from any kind of sickness we had ever before. Everyone who got sick had chest pains and pains in their foreheads. Our legs and arms were cold and numb. What wickedness." Just a few years ago in this century, International Solidarity Group purchased the freedom of 5,514 slaves in devil-dominated nations, raising the total number of slaves freed through the organization to 20,961. The price per slave at that time was approximately $50. The world is crazy. I can see the spirit of Jezebel here with us right now. We now see wickedness everywhere, in the business lines, families, societies, even the church, which where we seen before as the hope of a common man. By this spirit, we have records of hatred and injustice. May God save his children. It is a spirit of loving power in the kingdom of Israel. The spirit turned Ahab, the king, to a queen and made the Amazon Jezebel to a king. When you read the story of Ahab and the vineyard of Naboth, 1 Kings 21, verses 5 to 7, you shall see how Jezebel pet the king. So let's go to the Word of God. Go to 1 Kings chapter 21, verses 5 through 7. But Jezebel, his wife, came to him and said unto him, "Why is thy spirit so sad? But thou eatest no bread." And he said unto her, "Because I spake unto Naboth the Jezreelite, and he said unto me, Give me thy vineyard for money, or else, if it please thee, I will give thee another vineyard for it." And he answered, "I will not give thee my vineyard." And Jezebel, his wife, said unto him, "Dost thou now govern the kingdom of Israel? Arise and eat the bread, and let thy heart be merry. I will give thee the vineyard of Naboth the Jezreelite." Can you see her assurance and confidence? Brethren, when this spirit manifests, it goes with negative powers. Jezebel wrote a letter to the king, sealed it with his name, okay, and sent it to the elders and the nobles in the city for the execution of Naboth. Disobeying her order is a punishable crime. What are we not seeing these days? Today, you hear of intimidation and oppression. If you have ever wondered why so many women look so masculine and tough with lust to dominate, you have your answer. It is the spirit of Jezebel. Brethren, when you see such conditions as we are seeing, you know we are in that time, which is said to be a space to repent, which can also be called the eve of destruction. The Bible never directs us to seek power, rather wisdom and understanding, Proverbs chapter 4, verse 7. Wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore get wisdom, yeah, with all thy getting understanding. The fear of the Lord is wisdom, and to forsake evil is understanding. That is what Job said in the book of Job 28, verse 28. Do you fear the Lord, or does this spirit dominate you? I want to assist you to regain your freedom in the Lord. Dear brethren, I know where you are now, hearing my voice. Through this A Voice in the Desert series, I'm calling your heart and mind back to your Maker. It's not a time for hide and seek. We are talking about your eternal rest after your life here on earth. One dangerous thing about hell is not it's burning with sulfur and brimstones or the other sounds of agony to be heard, but it is a place to stay forever. I repeat, forever. And never again feel God, nor hear His voice, nor feel His love ever again. Dear brethren, this message is coming to you now because you are not in a casket or in a grave yet. You still have an opportunity to repent and turn away from all your evils. 2 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 2 says, "For he saith, at an acceptable time I hearken unto thee, and in a day of salvation I did succor thee. Behold, now is the acceptable time. Behold, now is the day of salvation. Have you seen it? Now is the accepted time, the day of salvation. Will you miss it?" Again, the book of Isaiah, chapter 55, verses 6 through 7 says, "Seek ye Jehovah while he may be found. Call ye upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his ways, and the unrighteous man his thoughts, and let him return unto Jehovah, and he will have mercy upon him, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon." Surely, if you come to the Lord today, he will pardon your transgressions and make you a brand new person. Are you ready to surrender your life to Jesus Christ? If you have not done so, and you want to follow him, and you want to be in his ways, I will pray with you for your salvation, and together our voice will reach the Lord for your salvation. In our next segment, in the prayer of salvation, we're going to pray that with you. I pray that you pray that prayer earnestly, because your life depends on it. Once again, my name is Caesar. I'm a voice in the desert. Next week, we will cover series 2 of The Evil Spirit of Jezebel. Don't miss it. God bless you.
If there is any here that is listening and wants to leave their old self behind, and this message has shown you that some needed change has to take place, and you have never accepted Jesus Christ as your Savior, or you ran away from God for whatever reason, and you want to reconcile yourself back to Him, let's pray this simple prayer of salvation. Dear God in heaven, I come to you in the name of Jesus. I acknowledge to you that I am a sinner, and I am sorry for my sins and the life that I have lived. I need your forgiveness. I believe that you are the only begotten Son of Jesus Christ, who shed his precious blood on the cross at Calvary and died for my sins. And I am now willing to turn from my sins. You said in your holy word, Romans 10:9, that if we confess the Lord our God and believe in our heart that God raised Jesus from the dead, we shall be saved. Right now, I confess Jesus as the Lord of my soul. With my heart, I believe that God raised Jesus from the dead. This very moment, I accept Jesus Christ as my own personal Savior, and according to His word, right now, I am saved. Thank you for your unlimited grace, which has saved me from my sins. I thank you, Jesus, that your grace never leads to license, but rather always leads to repentance. Therefore, Lord Jesus, transform my life so that I may bring glory and honor to you alone and not myself. Thank you, Jesus, for dying for me and giving me eternal life. Amen. If you have earnestly prayed this salvation prayer, I want to say that the angels in heaven are rejoicing. And what I want to say, thank you, brother, for you have just become a reborn Christian. You have become a son of the Most High. Jesus Christ. Once again, thank you and welcome to the family. God bless you.
Hi all, we just didn't want to let you go before telling us all the other places that you can find us on social media so you can enjoy our messages. First place that you should always go to should be to our website, where you will find all of our latest blogs up to date. And that's going to be at www.avoiceinthedesert.net. Okay, there you'll find all our archived podcasts. You can also follow us on Facebook at A Voice in the Desert 2017. Okay, you also can follow us by on our blogs, okay, which is My Walk with My Creator. blogspot.com. I'm going to repeat that again for you. My Walk with My Creator. blogspot.com. And if you think that was the end of it, we got another surprise. You can also follow us on Twitter, okay? And our handle on Twitter is A the Desert. That's where you're going to find the voice in the desert, at the handle A the Desert. Okay, so follow us there so you can get our tweets throughout the day and some encouraging messages. You can also listen to our podcast in iHeartRadio. All you have to do is search for A Voice in the Desert and like us there and put us down as your favorite. And you can listen to us on your daily commute as you're going back and forth in your car and listen to us at your leisure or at your home. Okay? If you think that was enough, we got another surprise. You can find us at iTunes, okay? On Podcast iTunes, just search for A Voice in the Desert, and you're going to find us right there. And all you have to do is subscribe to it. Anytime a new podcast is out, it will automatically be downloaded onto your device, okay? You can also follow us at Stitcher Radio. All you have to do is search for A Voice in the Desert. You're going to find us, follow us, and you'll be able to listen to us at your leisure. Okay? And but always, your first recourse should be www.avoiceinthedesert.net. There you will have all our archived latest messages, and also downloaded materials that we provide for you for your learning experience. Okay? Once again, thank you for listening to us. God bless you. And can't wait to give you our next message on next week. Okay? Take care. Bye.